Good morning everyone. Okay? Yes. Today, in our situation is very dynamic situation. Okay? That's why the children, you are stay home, stay safe. Today, I will discuss with you the most important point of view. Okay, what that means? The parts of speech. Parts of speech. Parts of speech. Okay. First of all, I introduce myself. My name is Saubhagya Lakshmi. I am working as English CRT from KGBV CK Pali. Okay. Now, I will explain to you what is a part of speech. Do you know what is a part of speech? Please tell me anyone. Yes. The parts of speeches are divided into 8 categories. The parts of speeches are divided into 8 categories. First of all, we watch what is a part of speech. Okay, what is the definition of parts of speech? Okay, I will what is a parts of speech, what is the definition of the parts of speech. Parts of speeches means according to a function, according to the word, according to a function, according to a word, they do in a sentence. They do in a sentence, that is called a parts of speech. What is the parts of speech means? According to a function, according to the word, they do in a sentence. They do in a sentence, that is called a part of speech. Part of speech. Okay, are you understood, children? What is a part of speech? According to a function, according to the word, they do in a sentence. That is called a part of speech. Okay? Yes. Already we are discuss about how many parts of speeches are there. How to identify the parts of speeches? How to identify parts of speeches? Yes. Some words will tell the names. Some words perform the action. Some words show the position. Okay? Some words will tell the names. Some words perform the action. Some words show the position. That is called a parts of speech. Okay? In our English language, the thousands of words we are discussing. Okay? The thousands of words we are discussing in our English language. The words are divided into 8 categories. Okay, the words are divided into 8 categories. That means how many parts of speeches are there? Means 8 parts of speeches. The parts of speeches are divided into 8 categories. Okay, first of all, we are now discussing about parts of speeches. How many parts of speeches are there? Okay, what is the definition of parts of speech? How to identify the parts of speeches in our English language? Okay, already we learn 8 categories are there in parts of speech. Yes, the first one is noun. The first one is noun. The second one is pronoun. The first one is noun. The second one is pronoun. The third one is verb. The fourth one is adjective. adjective. The fourth one is adjective. The fifth one is adverb. The fifth one is adverb. The sixth one is preposition. The sixth one is preposition. And the second one is conjunction. The sixth, seventh one is conjunction. The eighth one is interjection. The eighth one is interjection. Okay, do you know, children, how many parts of speeches are there? Yes, eight parts of speeches are there in our English language. The first one is pronoun. The second one is, the first one is noun. The second one is pronoun. The third one is verb. The fourth one is adjective. The fifth one is adverb. The sixth one is preposition. The seventh one is conjunction. The eighth one is interjection. This is our eight parts of speeches. Okay, in our English language, more words are there. More words having in our English language. Okay, and the words are divided into eight categories. The eight categories are called parts of speech. Okay, now I will discuss with you what is a noun. Okay, what is a noun? The noun. What is noun? Anybody please tell me, the children. Do you know? How many parts of speeches are there? First we learn how many parts of speeches are there. Okay, eight parts of speeches are there. Already we learn what is the definition of parts of speech. Okay, yes. Now I will discuss with you what is a noun. Okay, now noun means names a person, place, things or items. Okay, what is means of noun? Noun means names of a person, place, things or items. Okay, you understood, the children? Yes. What is the definition of noun? What is the means of noun? Means names a person, place, things or items. For example, house, teacher, cup, shop. These are called noun. Okay. For example, Lata is a very nice person. Okay. Do you identify what is the noun in this example? Okay. Very good. Lata is a noun. Okay. Beautiful girl. She is a beautiful girl. Here we use pronoun. Why? Because we didn't use more than in the place of noun. Okay. Yes. She is a beautiful girl. How? That means here or the I will explain another time. The pronoun means replace the name of a person, thing, or idea in a sentence. For example, I, she, he, it, they. Okay, what is the examples of pronoun? I, she, he, it, they. Okay, tell me the sentence. Tell me one sentence, please. Children, do you understood what is a pronoun? Do you understood what is a noun? Now, we will explain pronoun because tell me the one your sentence, please. Okay, he is a very clever boy. Very good. Okay, he is a very clever boy. Okay, do you identify what is a pronoun in the sentence? Yes, he is a very clever boy. Very good. Yes, next, now we are going to work is most important point in important speech in our part of speech. What? How? Because our heart is how the important our human body. The verb is at the same time the verb is also a most important speech in our part of speech. The verb is most important part. The verb is most important point in our parts of speech. Yes, what is the definition of parts of a verb? Verb means describes an action. Describes an action or experience. Yes, what is the definition of verb? Describes an action or experience. Okay, action. What action you will observe in our class, in our playground, in our villages? What actions do you observe? Anybody please tell me. Yes. Okay, first of all, I will give some examples. After you will give me some sentences or some examples. Okay, children? Yes. Verb means describes an action or experience. The example means run, walk, push, eat. Okay, examples. Run, walk, push, eat. Okay, do you understand, children? Yes. I will give one sentence to you. Radha ran to school because she was late. Radha ran to school because she was late. Here, what is the word? Do you know? Yes. What is the word? Which word do you observe in verb? Hey. Yes. Ran is a verb. Because here describes an action. Here description, action. Do you know the first we discuss about noun, pronoun? In this sentence, we are also observing the name. Okay, the noun. The noun also we are observing the sentence. Okay, we are all now discuss about verb means. Here the verb is identified here, ran. Okay? Yes. Some other, please give me your what do you listen? What do you understand? Okay? Yes. Here I will give one more example. Laddu loves to read books. Here, which word do you identify here? Okay, yes, here read is a verb because here performs an action. Okay, are you understood, children? Yes. Please tell me some more examples. Okay. Now, Sita goes to school. Sita goes to school. Here, which one is verb? Yes, here goes to verb. Okay, this is the most most important point to complete the sentence. This is a meaningful sentence. Okay, when we didn't use a verb, this is not a sentence, this is incomplete sentence. Okay, verb is most important. How the most important to the verb in our English language means to the in the sentence also, here goes to the very important to the sentence. Okay, this is a meaningful sentence. Okay, the next one is yes, now the fourth part of speech is adverb. Adverb means adverb. Yes, what is adverb? Adverb, do you know, children? Yes, adverb means describes a verb, an adjective, or an adverb. Yes, adverb definition means describes a verb, an adjective, or an adverb. The adverb tells us how often, how, where, or when. Adverb means describes a word, describes a word, an adjective, or an adverb. How to identify adjective? Adjective means, for example, slowly, yesterday, always, round, big. Okay, these ones are adjective, adverb. Adverbs are most, this is also most important to the in our part of speech. Verb, how to important the verb is how to most important in our English language. The adverb also most important to in our English language. Yes, here I will write one example. Lata is always late for school. Lata is always late for school. Here the adverb is always. Here the adverb is always. Next one, the last night I slept really well. Okay, Lata is always late for school. Last night I slept really well. Here the adverb is always. Okay, please, do you understand what is adverb? Yes, the children, do you observe what is adverb? Yes, I will tell one more time. What is the definition of this adverb? Describes a verb, an adjective, or an adverb. Okay, have you understood what? Yes, give me some example of adverb. Yes, please tell me, children. Okay, he sat slowly on the bench. Very good. Very good, children. He sat slowly on the bench. Very good. Which one is the adverb you were identifying in the sentence? Yes. Slowly is most important. Slowly is the adverb part in the sentence. Okay. Yes. Are you understood what is adverb? What is noun? What is pronoun? What is a verb? Okay. Very good. Please tell me. Some examples, some more examples. Okay. She always argue with me. She always argue with me. Yes. Do you identify what is the adverb in the sentence? Yes. Always. Always is in the adverb is in the sentence. Okay. Yes. Now I will explain another part of speech. The fifth part of speech is adjective. This is also a most important part of speech this is the most important speech in the part of speech. Okay. Yes. Adjective. Adjective. What is the definition of adjective means? Describes a noun or a pronoun. Adjective means describes a noun or a pronoun. That means how to identify a person. This is big or tall, small, etc. Okay, yes. Here I will give some examples of adjective. Short, beautiful, red, old. Okay, are you understood what is adjective? Yes. chapati. Okay, are you understood? What is adjective? Okay, yes. Adjective means describes a noun or a pronoun. For example, short, beautiful, red, word. We will give some more examples also. Here, we make a sentence here. See, observe children carefully. Sheena is a beautiful girl. Okay? Here the beautiful is adjective. Sheena is a beautiful girl. Okay, are you understood now? Yes. Then the second one, Raghu is a short boy. Raghu is a short boy. Please tell me anyone, which one is adjective you are identifying? Yes, tell me children. Yes, short. Short is an adjective in this sentence. Okay, do you understand? Yes. Please tell me an example. Please tell me, children. Okay. Sarala is a short girl. Sarala is a short girl. Which one is adjective in the sentence? Short. Short is a adjective. Okay, please tell me some more. She makes big chapati. She makes a big chapati in our home or in our home. Okay, she makes a big chapati at home. Are in home or at home. Okay, here didn't use in. Okay, we use at home. Yes, here which one is adjective? Do you identify? Yes, the big. Big is here adjective. Big is a adjective. Yes. Now, next one is preposition. The next part of speech is preposition. This is most important point of in our English language. This is the most parts of how to work. This is the most important parts of speech in our English language. The preposition also the most important part of speech. Yes. What is the definition of preposition? Yes. Preposition definition means describes the place, time or direction it is used before a noun or a pronoun. Preposition is, it is used as a noun or pronoun. Okay? Yes. Describes the place. Which place do you observe? Time or direction. Which time we are going? Which time we are taken? This time. Time or direction, it is used before a noun. It is used how to use the noun in the place, in the before noun or after a pronoun. Okay? Example, under, above, in, during. Okay? The example is under, above, in, during. How to identify the preposition? How to use preposition in the sentence? Yes. Here, I will give some examples. All of you listen carefully. The cat jumped over the box. The cat jumped over the box. Here, which one is the preposition? Please tell me the children. Yes. Here, the preposition is over. Here, the preposition is over. Here, the over is, here the over is preposition. This is the, we make, we use preposition in the sentence. This is a meaningful sentence. Okay? In the preposition. preposition here. Okay, before is a preposition here. We started to go to school before timing. We started to go to school before timing. We didn't go to after timing to school. We come in our school in timing. Okay, before timing, in timing. We didn't go after school timing. Okay, all of you understood, children? Yes. In the first sentence, over is the preposition, and the second sentence before is the preposition. Are you understood? Yes. Please tell me some more examples. What you have understood? Yes, preposition. Now we are going to preposition part. Yes, tell me one sentence. What you understood? Okay. The girl sat under a tree. Under a tree. Very good, children. Okay. All of you understood what is a preposition? Yes. The children. Very good, children. You will give a meaningful sentence. Okay. You will give an example, a meaningful sentence. Okay. The girl sat under a tree. Which one is do you identify? Preposition in the sentence. Okay. Under. Very good. Under is a preposition here. Okay. Very good. Please give me some more examples about. Yes. Tell me. The students are in the classroom. Very good. The students are in the classroom. You are all in the classroom now? Yes. The students are in the classroom. And listen the class. And listen the classes. And listen the classes. Very good. Here, which one is you identify preposition? In. In is the preposition here. Okay? Yes. All of you understood what is adverb, what is adjective, what is a preposition? Yes. Okay. Now, the seventh parts of speech is conjunction. Okay, first of all, we are already six parts of speeches we discussed. The first one, noun, pronoun, verb, adjective, adverb, preposition. Now, we are going to conjunction. Yes, conjunction.
I like to watch television and eat laddu.
conjunction. Okay, do you identify which one is the conjunction? Yes, where? Okay, do you understand what is the conjunction? Yes, we use in the middle of the sentence and, but, and, or. Okay, we use in the one person to one person, we use some linkers. Why? Because in a meaningful sentence. Okay, please tell me examples about conjunction. Okay. Conjunction. Do you understand what is a conjunction? Conjunction means linkers. We use in the middle of the sentence some linkers we use with meaningful sentences. Okay. First, please give me one example of and. Okay. Example is I and you are going to, which place do you like most? Tirupati. Tirupati. Okay. Here, which one is conjunction do you identify? Very good. And is conjunction here. Okay. And is conjunction here. I and you are going to Tirupati. Okay, very good. Here we identify the conjunction is and. Okay, yes. Please give me some more examples about conjunction. But are or. Okay, yes. Sheena. Sheila are. In the children, what is the example? One more example of conjunction. Yes. We are going to Tirumala or Tirupati. Okay, here, which one do you identify? Identify the conjunction. Okay, here, Tirumala is Tirumala and Tirupati is the same places. Okay, because of we are use R here. Okay, do you understand what is the conjunction? Yes, now we are going to the last part of speech. Interjection. Do you know the children, what is the interjection? Interjection. What is the interjection? What is the definition of interjection? Means express strong emotions and is often followed by an exclamation mark. Okay? Express strong emotions. For example, we saw a snake in our classroom. How we express our emotion? Okay, yes, this one is the expression of our emotions. How to, when we saw a snake in our classroom, what is the expression of ours? Okay, yes, express strong emotion and is often followed by an exclamation mark. Here, when we use expression words, here we put here interjection mark. Wow, oh, ah, ala, this one. Okay, here expressing strong emotion and is often followed by an exclamation mark. Here compulsory we put the interjection mark. Do you observe here? Please do you observe here, children? Wow, oh, here put the interjection mark. Okay, all of you understood? Yes, I will give some examples of interjection. Wow, the view is amazing. Yes, we express our emotions in this interjection. Yes, wow, the view is amazing. Here I will question mark. Okay? Yes. Please tell me some more examples of interjections. Do you understood the children? Do you understood what is the interjection? Yes. Please give me some examples. Okay. It's amazing. It's amazing. Very good. Here, which one is the way to identify interjection? Okay. Yes. The next. Wow. It's a beautiful morning. Wow, it's a beautiful morning. Here, which one is do you observe interjection? Yes, wow. And also, we put here exclamation mark also. Okay, yes. This one is, it's amazing. Wow, it's a beautiful morning. Okay, do you understood? The intersection, what is the definition of intersection? Okay, I will explain one more time. Expressing strong emotion and the hand is often followed by an exclamation mark. Yes, wow. Oh. Okay, children. Do you understand what is the purpose of speeches? Yes, very good. Yes. I will ask some questions to you. Okay, children. Yes. How many parts of speeches are there? Yes. The parts of speeches are divided into 8 categories. Very good. Okay. 8 categories. Yes. Yes. What is the parts of speech? Okay. What is the parts of speech? Anybody means? Yes. Parts of speech means according to the function, according to the word, okay, according to the function, according to the word, they do in a sentence, okay, they do in a sentence, it is called a part of speech. Okay, children, according to a function, according to a word, they do in a sentence, that is called a part of speech. Okay, parts of speeches are divided into how many categories? 8 categories. 8 categories. Parts of speeches are divided into 8 categories. This is the most important point of in our English language. In our English language, more thousands of words are there. Okay? That words are divided into 8 categories. That is called a part of speech. Okay? Yes. In our English language, having a more than words. We are pronoun, which word is conjunction, which word is adjective, which word is preposition, which word is conjunction, which word is interjection. Now we are easily identified which part of speech we are in the sentence, which part of speech we are mentioned in the sentence. Okay, do you know all of you? Do you understood? Yes, very good. Okay, now we are going to, we are discussing 8 categories or 8, in our parts of speech are divided into 8 categories. Already we learned what is the meaning of parts of speech, what is the definition of parts of speech, how to use in our daily life parts of speeches. Okay, how many categories are there in our parts of speech? 8 categories. Okay, now pronoun, verb, adjective, adverb, preposition, conjunction, interjection. This is the most important point of important parts of speeches are in our English language. Okay, are you understood, children? Yes. Okay, thank you for giving this opportunity. Children, okay, we've understood the parts of speeches, okay? I will give some homework to you, okay? Yes. Write down your homework, children. Yes. What is a part of speech? What is a part of speech? And second one is, how many parts of speeches are there? How many parts of speeches are there? And third, give some examples of verb and adverb. Give some examples of verb and adverb. Do you understood the children? Do you understood now? What is the parts of speech? How many parts of speeches are there? Give some examples of verb and adverb. And the fourth one is how to identify, how to identify conjunction and interjection. How to identify conjunction and interjection. Okay, this is your homework. Okay. WhatsApp group, okay?